Social media now has the power to affect an entire generation, young and old, changing people from different personas, but at what cost? At what cost are people willing to change themselves entirely for likes and attention? In this documentary, we're gonna be taking a look at the eyes behind the like. In today's society, having a persona is the latest trend to interact with people on social media. By creating these personas, users are able to gain more followers and traction with their own content. We asked social media users on how they felt as their followers increased.
I just thought it was kind of funny in a way because I didn't really expect it at all. I just thought like a few people would like it, but actually a lot of people thought it was pretty clever what I posted and started getting more followers. I actually liked what I did and posted.
When I first started getting traction to my followers, I felt as if I was making an impact and I was getting noticed a lot on other platforms. I was doing things that were different that make people want to come back and being talkative in my chat and really getting to know my community.
When I first started cosplaying, I wasn't expecting people outside of my friend group to follow me. And when I started reaching numbers that I never expected I would reach, I was surprised because I didn't realize people would follow me because for my content.
I thought it was cool. I just thought it was like, okay, it's really a thing that I should like pay attention to, because I didn't really look at it as a serious thing until people actually started saying, you know, oh, you should probably, you know, profit out of this, or, you know, make a career out of this. And it's always been in the back of my head because, you know, obviously I do it because I like it. So wouldn't it be nice to make that, what is that saying? Make your passion your paycheck.
What is the deciding factor for creating a persona? What may cause a person to change themselves or their beliefs?
Conformity is a very complex topic, but put very simply, conformity is the tendency for people, when a large group does something, to mimic or to follow that group. Conformity is a means of social survival, right? If you see a bunch of people running away in a certain direction, you're gonna run in that direction, probably for a good reason.
The pressure to keep such persona is higher than ever.
Definitely, it feels kind of like you're obligated to post something that will entertain them, not necessarily something you'd enjoy personally. I definitely get that. Like, my follower rate definitely fluctuates and influctuates, like, depending on what I post, depending if I like it or a majority will like it.
I definitely agree that you have to make a bigger impact on all of your followers when you do have more followers, because they're all looking at you and they're all making their judgment and their decisions. I need to make sure that everything is appropriate and according to like my own opinion, the best like way I could possibly portray myself and my stream.
So whenever my post doesn't get any likes, I feel kind of disappointed and a little bit embarrassed. So sometimes I find myself deleting those posts, even though I'm fully aware that no one cares. If anything, it makes me want to provide better content for my audience. They've been with me for a couple of years now, so I feel obligated to give them the content that they followed me for.
In some cases, users become accustomed to their personas and evolve for their audience.
So basically I feel like I have three personas. One where it's me being super happy, like smiling, like, hey guys, what's up? And then another one where it's me being really tilted, me being really sad. It's like, hey, like I'm having a really rough day. And then there's another one that's just like, I can't believe I died there. Like that was, oh my God. I'm usually shy in real life, but once I open up to people, those three come out a lot.
Even though I know that I should probably be myself, but I also find myself creating different personas depending on what social media outlet that I'm posting on. For example, for Instagram, I feel like I put on this like very pure, kind of innocent kind of persona, and I always like to act cutesy and stuff, even though I'm kind of more sassy in real life.
I still do some posts, but I have to like keep up this like other new standard of like, oh, I can't just post like a regular selfie or like a regular whatever. Like it has to be like at a different level, or at least my own level, or my standards I guess I have in my head.
to some extent, everybody takes on a different persona in a different public or in a different sphere, right? So the way that I'm at Ohlone is not the way that I'm with my friends, it's not the way that I'm with my family. To some degree, we all have different personas, right?
In some cases, personas are looked down upon.
Personally, I would explain it as like a spike of happiness. Like, wow, I did well, I'm glad people liked it. But then there's also that like downside to where that means I have to post more content like this, and I have to focus more on this, and am I gonna be able to post something like this that people will like again, you know what I mean?
Some content creators see personas as a positive aspect of social media.
I wouldn't say like be yourself, because if you want to and you can be yourself, then that's great. But some people find it hard to be themselves on social media. Sometimes they want to put on this persona, and I don't think that's necessarily a bad thing. Sometimes it's just a matter of time. Some people need to start that way and then slowly insert their personality.
I've been too real, I've been too fake, where I try to put a smile, you know. It's more so the people that know what's going on with my life. They say, why are you smiling? You have this going on and this going on. In reality, I just want my shame atmosphere to be positive. Like, if I'm sad, my motive is to make them happy, and in turn, that will make me happy.
American society, we really promote and we idealize being an individual. We idealize being authentic and being your true self, right? But what is your true self but a version of different selves that you have with different people, right? And it's not necessarily to say that one is better or worse.
The pressures of society has cut deep into the minds of the social media users. However, their self of sense worth and individuality are what they value the most.
I think through the art I'm studying my real self, but I think, you know, I guess with subjectivity, like, I'm being taken as the art too, where it's like they're seeing it and they're interpreting it. Like, they interpret me as like this serious, cold person. There's times where people come up to me and they're just like, I thought you were gonna be really serious and cold, and I'm like, what do you mean by that? They're like, well, I don't know, you like don't smile, or like, I thought you were gonna be super like uptight or something. I'm like, I don't know about that, but like, you know, it's like I am what I am. I'm like, you see what you wanna see, but what's behind is completely different, you know?
Like, it's very important to stick to who you are. There's so many people in the world, like, why would you try like being like someone else? Like, you should definitely like do what you want. If people don't like it, that's not your problem, you know? Because someone out there will like it. If you're being true to yourself, people will see that and people will appreciate and respect you.
Conformity is most definitely prevalent in social media, but this necessarily isn't a bad thing. One good notion can change the ideals and the way people think about a certain subject. But on contrast, a negative action can change the way and desensitize the people think about an ideal. Which begs the question, what do you see when you take eyes behind the like?
Oh my God, what's taking so long? Are we still meeting up? Okay, same place. See you there.
Curry. Oh.
No, my refrigerator isn't running. Should it be?
Bill, we have an anonymous tip about a deal going down. We've been tracking this guy down for a while now. Sources said a neighbor was checking out his house and a bunch of guys were going out of his house with a bunch of suspicious packages.
Wow. Not even a hello. A douche.
Can you just get this done and be a little bit more serious, please?
Yeah, I got it.
It's not like you can do this professionally, right?
But you know there's a chance, right?
Just get it done.
Are you the guy?
Yeah, you got the stuff?
Yeah, show me the money first.
Breathe! Don't move! Put the bag down slowly!
Which one is it? Don't move or put the bag down slowly? Lego my ego. I should be safe in here. What?
Oh, thank God it's you. Last person to walk in was a pregnant lady.
Give me that bag.
What's wrong with buying a toy?
You're free to go.
Thanks, douche.
I'm so gonna get fired.
We'll be right back. tired of you not caring. You know I hate it when you do that. It doesn't help that you don't even try to hide it. That just shows how much you care about our relationship.
That's rich coming from you. You couldn't care less if I dropped dead right now. I highly doubt you even love me.
What do you mean you highly doubt I even love you? I spend all my time with you. I don't even hang out with my friends anymore because of you.
Don't blame me for your lack of social skills. You barely hold a conversation with anyone. Don't try to justify you not having any friends because of me, when we both know it's you. You're the reason.
I see you've come across that beauty. It used to belong to my great-grandmothers. She said whoever gifted it to their lover was destined to have a never-ending and loving relationship with them.
That's interesting.
If you look inside the ring, it's actually said to have tally marks for every person who's worn the ring before. Were you interested in purchasing it? It does look quite lovely on you.
Thanks. I was thinking of buying it for my girlfriend. Got in a fight last night and it'll make the perfect apology gift.
I'm sure she'll love it, and that you'll have a never-ending and loving relationship with her.
Let's just hope what you say about the ring is true. Harlow, can we please talk?
There's nothing to talk about.
Look, I'm sorry about last night. Okay, I was being insensitive and rude, and I shouldn't have said the things that I said. Can you please say something? Or at least look at me.
You know, I just worry about you. I don't want anything to happen to you.
I know, and I'm sorry, and that's why I got you this gift as an apology. It's not an engagement ring, it's more of an I'm sorry ring. I wanted to remind you that even if I say something stupid, I still love you.
You're so sweet. I guess I accept your apology. And I woke up to my finger feeling like it was being torched. But that doesn't make sense. There's nothing hot around here.
Let me see that ring.
What are those marks?
The guy I bought it from said that these marks are the number of people who wore the ring.
Kira, let me see your hand. Look, you have the same mark as me. Did you not feel pain when it appeared?
No, I didn't, actually. This is so weird. How do you think that happened? I tried the ring on before I gave it to you. Do you think that's it?
Possibly. We should go visit the guy that sold you the ring. Maybe he knows why he leaves this mark.
Excuse me, sir? Oh, hey! So how'd your girl like the ring?
Her girl loved the ring. If you don't mind, I have some questions about the ring.
Sorry about that. She's my girl.
Don't say sorry, and my apologies for that. Also, I don't do returns, so you're not getting your money back.
That's not what we're here for. I put the ring on and woke up with this number burned onto my finger. And so did Kira.
Not my problem. Now, if you don't mind, could you leave your in my cell?
Guy, we just want to know if you know anything about this ring and if it's possible to have caused this mark. And don't pretend that you don't know anything about it because you were saying it's your great-grandmother's and you were happy to tell me about how it magically fixes relationships.
Fine. But if I tell you, you have to promise to leave me alone.
Yeah, sure. Spill the beans.
It's a cursed item. Whoever wears the ring has 7 days to live. Seeing as you bought the ring yesterday, and you're both marked, I'm assuming you both wore it.
That's the most explanation I've ever heard in my life.
Listen, you came to me. I didn't come to you. So, once that mark appeared on your finger, you knew something was... Now, if you do not mind, I would really like to go back to reading my book, and I would appreciate it if you stayed out of my life. I want nothing to do with the both of you.
Here's my name and address. If you decide not to be such an... Has to be a joke.
Harlow, that's not funny!
What is it funny?
That wasn't you? He wasn't lying. What the fuck? Okay, no. This is crazy. No, the stress is just getting to me. That's...
Kira, honey, tell me what's going on. You're not crazy.
I saw a girl outside, and I came to check at the door, and it says 5 days.
So it wasn't just me.
What do you mean it wasn't just you?
At work, I got this weird error message saying the same thing you saw in the window.
What are we gonna do? The guy that sold us the ring doesn't want to help us. We don't even know what we're dealing with.
I'm sure there's a book that has information on what this thing is.
There. Okay. Where's the card? Here. Kira, just pick up the phone. Just pick up the phone. Come on, pick up the phone, Kira. Pick up the phone. Pick up the phone, Kira. Pick up the phone.
So it wasn't just me.
I mean, it wasn't. No, I'm crazy. It's just the stress. It's getting to me. That's all.
Yikes. That's me. I'm Tessa Roberts, and I may have wasted this entire semester to last night's sheer stupidity.
Oh, hey. Where are you going?
Home.
What's been up with you lately?
Dude, I'm so deprived. I've just had finals literally this whole week, and I just have one more tomorrow, and I just want to go home.
Hey, you're not trying to leave, are you?
Girl, I'm trying.
We all have finals tomorrow. Don't worry about it.
All right, you know what? It's 11. It's still early. Take these. We're just gonna have fun tonight, okay?
Sounds good.
And cheers!
That was the last thing I remember.
Hey Tess, I'm parked outside waiting. You're not answering your phone, and it's about 11:15. I've got finals too, so I have to go. Text me and Liz and let us know you're alive.
I'm surprised she even wanted to stay till 3.
Let's call her one more time. I don't know if she knows that the test is up here.
I mean, she's probably just sleeping anyway, but I can try again, I guess.
I'd see how you're feeling.
Hey, I'm all right. I just have an exam and like right now.
Do you have a second?
No.
I just want to talk real quick.
You know what? I would really love it, but do you know what time it is maybe?
11:55.
Okay, cool. Yeah, thanks. No, have a good one.
Hey, I was going to say, if you want to borrow my scooter, go ahead.
Really?
Yeah.
Okay, cool. Thanks. Thanks so much. Sorry for earlier. Bye.
All right, students, the test will now commence. You have 1 hour to complete it.
So, how's you guys' test?
Oh, God.
Hey, where were you? I didn't think you were gonna make it.
You guys, I am so dead. I've been running around all morning, and I don't even remember what happened last night.
Well, you and Liz are gonna grab lunch, so...
Okay, thanks for the invite.
You have plans.
Yeah, I'm busy.
Oh, hey, you're still here. I almost forgot to give it back to you. Here you go.
Thanks.
Yeah, no worries.
I still have no idea what happened, so how about we go get lunch and maybe we can talk about it?
You don't know the half of it, trust me. But anyway, so the test, like, you know.
Can I get a world, can I get a world star?
Oh, hey, wanna see something? Okay.
Take these. We're just gonna have fun tonight, okay?
Sounds good.
Here's to the semester.
I just
got
a shot in my
head. Oh, I noticed it. I was...
Wakey, wakey.
What the heck was that for, Russell?
It's time to wake up.
With hot water, really?
You're so dead.
Come back here. Russell!
Hey, Carrie, I'm doing good. Got your mail by accident, because mailmen are weird.
Thank you so much. Is there something else?
Oh, just one more thing. There's this Chinese restaurant opened up a couple weeks ago. I was wondering if maybe you wanted to come with me?
I don't know, Hank. I don't know if my kids are ready to see someone new in their life. And honestly, I don't know if I am either.
Well, what about the things we talked about last night? Or when we kissed on New Year's?
I was so wasted.
You drove home.
Because I'm a certified gangsta lady. You know this. Can we talk about this tonight? Goodbye, Hank.
So, what's up with Dennis?
Well, Dennis wants to become the greatest basketball player ever. So I can ask out his future bae. I don't know what a bae is, but it sounds like a girl. I don't know why you're trying to ask out a girl. They're way too hard to figure out anyway.
Son, don't even begin to understand girls or try to understand girls. I was one, and I don't even always understand it. But you know what? I bet if there was a manual about understanding girls, it would probably sell faster than the Bible.
Well, scientifically proven that kids with high voices get beat up and bullied more than kids who don't. So I figured if my voice is lower and masculine, that would decrease my ratio of getting bullied by 30%, along with other data I required.
Oh yeah, I heard that too. Right.
Mom!
Lay it on me, Dennis. Let me hear it.
I am going into the NBA.
Go change. You look like Dennis Rodman in the 90s.
I have no words for you.
Shut up, Russell.
If I learn anything from Instagram, it's hashtag rise above my hater.
Go change. And throw away those short shorts. You're making Russell feel uncomfortable.
Mommy?
What?
Mommy?
What is this, son? What?
The kitchen's on fire.
What?
Thank you.
times we struggle, sometimes our days are hard, but you can make it if you keep your trust in God. A mom's hard work is never really done. Working hard, doing it all, and raising two sons. 'Cause this morning, we gotta get up and go. And yes, this morning, to create our own. Oh, this morning, making the best of what we have. Working hard and trusting God to do what he can. This morning. Sometimes we struggle, sometimes our days are hard, but you can make it if you keep your trust in God. A mom's hard work is never really done. Working hard, doing it all, and raising two sons, 'cause this morning.